a lot of confusion in the church today about certain aspects of the charismatic gifts that are described in the New Testament. One of the foremost of those gifts is the gift of tongues. What was the gift of tongues? Well, that's a question that's very important for us to answer because it will determine whether or not we see legitimate uses of the supposed gift of tongues in the church today. I think the Bible makes it very clear that the gift of tongues was the supernatural ability to speak in previously unlearned foreign languages. In other words, tongues were authentic foreign languages. For somebody to be speaking in tongues meant they were speaking in a foreign language that they had never previously learned. I think we see this evidenced in three different ways. First of all, in terms of the word itself that is used to describe tongues. It's the Greek word glossa, which means language. It can also refer to the physical organ of the tongue, but it means language. And then secondly, we see the example of the apostles on the day of Pentecost. When they spoke in tongues on the day of Pentecost, Luke, in his description of Acts chapter 2, makes it very clear that they were speaking in foreign dialects. And even in 1 Corinthians 12-14, I think Paul makes it very clear that the tongues that he was speaking of in that context, again, were real languages. Chapter 14, verse 10, talks about all of the languages of the world. And he's talking about why the translation of tongues is so necessary. A foreign language untranslated is not edifying to those who don't understand it. And then in verse 21, he actually quotes from Isaiah 28:11, in which Isaiah was talking about foreign languages. So in Paul's writings in 1 Corinthians 12-14, in Acts chapter 2, and in the word itself, glossa, we have, I believe, conclusive evidence that the real gift of tongues consists of speaking authentic foreign languages. Anything that's not authentic foreign languages is not the real gift of tongues.